Hi guys! Welcome back to the tenorshare channel. Many Apple users responded that they could not use FaceTime after the system was upgraded to iOS 16, and even will be able to start new calls or receive a friend's phone call. Fortunately, I have found out some solutions to fix it. Let's dive in! First of all, let's do some pre-checks. 1. Make sure your network is available. 2. Make sure your FaceTime is on. One of the most common reasons why your FaceTime isn't working is because you haven't enabled FaceTime. So, just go to Settings. FaceTime on your iPhone. Here, make sure that FaceTime is turned on. 3. Make sure you allow FaceTime to use data both in WLAN and mobile data. Another common reason why your FaceTime isn't working is because you haven't enabled FaceTime to use data. If all the pre-check is okay, but your FaceTime still not working, try fix 1. Force restart your iPhone. A reboot might fix the issue too, so let's try it. Press the volume up and press the volume down button. Then press and hold the power button. Keep holding till the Apple logo appears. Next, we can just go ahead and reset all settings. Go to Settings. General Settings. Scroll down to Reset. And then reset all settings. After a restart, the first thing we want to make sure is connect to a stable network. Then sign in our FaceTime from scratch. After receding, do the pre-check things again. Next, a more straightforward solution would be using ReiBoot. Many Apple users responded that they could not use FaceTime after the system was upgraded to iOS 16. So the official launch of iOS 16.1 and iOS 16.2 to fix by repairing your phone in the standard mode through ReiBoot. You can get to the latest iOS 16.2 without losing any content. So let's dive in ReiBoot. Connect your phone to the PC first. Launch ReiBoot. Click the Start button. Standrad Repair. Here will require a download, just click it. Be patient. Wait for the download complete, it won't be long. Then click Start Standard Repair. The repair process might take some time. Do not disconnect your iPhone during the process, or it won't work. When it is done, FaceTime should work with no glitches. Moving on. If you don't want to upgrade your system to iOS 16.1 or 16.2, you can use ReiBoot to downgrade your iOS version. Bring your phone to iOS 15.7, which can help you to fix your FaceTime too. But make sure to back up your phone with iTunes first. Cause it will erase all your data in the process. Then we'll launch ReiBoot in the select iOS downgrade at the bottom. Click Deep Downgrade. After finish, your iOS system will back to iOS 15.7. Now you can back up your data from iTunes or iCloud. That's all for today's video. Thank you so much for watching. This is Tenorshare channel. See you in the next one.